Hey, is this not absolutely crazy? I'm able to put a video right here, talk to you, and give you the answers you wanted. Now, you asked a question about it: which cart is right for my state, or is this cart approved in my state, or which cart would be approved in my state, or which cart is best for my business? Well, believe it or not, for the last 8 years, that's the number one question I get asked, period. By far, every year, it makes the top of the top 10 list. And you'll see the link right above where I list you all 10 questions. I link you to the 10 questions I get asked by new people or even current vendors that ask questions. It's great that you would ask that question. It's a good question to ask. You want to get the right cart, right? Well, here's the deal. Each state has codes, okay? Some counties, actually, specifically in Washington State and California, have codes for each county. Different rules that apply, okay? They have to follow the state codes, but then they add some little extra ones just to keep things interesting. And I say that very facetiously. But the bottom line is, you don't want to really get a manufacturer's advice on which cart you need, other than the basics, because there's several variables. What are you serving? What time of day are you serving? What are you needing? What condiments are you having? All those things take into account, and I teach you that over on the first question on my top 10 list. You can link to it right above. But the biggest problem is when you're trying to avoid having to find out the codes, but I have the simple way to find out the codes in my free training. So you don't have to buy anything. You can get the information. I walk you step by step. It's real easy. Okay. I'm talking in the next 30 minutes to an hour, you can have all the information you need and have made one phone call and found out exactly what you need and emailed a health inspector the schematics of the cart you like. Let them be the one, because they're the ones that are going to approve you. Okay. Approve your cart. Let them be the ones to tell you, oh, Billy Bob, you can't have that on your cart. You can't. Or, oh, Sarah, you need to have 3 sinks, not 2. Or whatever it is, right? I have every state's codes. I already know them. I know them by heart. Almost by heart. I've done this a long time, and I've got every state's codes. And when they do updates, I get emails. I know the state codes. Problem is, you're getting my interpretation of your state codes. That doesn't mean it's your health inspector's interpretation of your state codes. So you want that person's. You want that person to tell you, oh, I've looked at these schematics on the Big Dog or the Cater Pro cart, and they look good except for that deep fryer that you want to put on there. You can't do that here. Or, hey, you want to do this. I want you to do this. Okay? Just simple things. Usually it's simple, and that's why our options on our cart, the free options, the ones that are free when you're buying a cart, outline the basic state codes so we know. That's why there's a choice between 1 sink, 2 sink, 3 sink, or 4. Let me give you an example. Florida, if you're in Florida, they only want 1 sink. In fact, they won't let you add 4, period. It's in the code, okay? Now, if you look up the code, it's a little bit confusing. Sounds like somebody with a degree in Egyptian hieroglyphics and possibly legal, like a legalese. You know, it's like Chinese on crack. Anyway, they've created this code that makes it sound like you need 4, but no. They only allow you to have 1 on an open cart in the state of Florida. So if you ordered a cart in the state of Florida with 4 sinks, done. But if you order a trailer, a concession trailer like our Stand King, you got to have 4. And some states require different sizes. So it's easy to do this. You don't have to do the research, actually. And I show you this step by step in my free training right above. Just click the free training button, go through it. It's real short. Okay. I can show you exactly what to do to get the right cart so that you don't waste a penny and you get everything you need on a cart and get approved. And you're open. And that's the most important. Okay? Whether you're buying it from me or not, follow these rules. I could have said, I'm just going to sell carts. I'm not going to teach. Okay? And I could probably, in fact, I know I could, sell more carts if I didn't give information, because people would just buy carts willy-nilly, get excited. I'm going to open me up. I'm going to have fried chicken livers and pig's feet in my cart, and I'm gonna do that every day, you know, that kind of thing. And I could go, oh, yeah, you'll need this cart then. Then they get it to Oklahoma and find out, oh, you can't have a deep fryer on a cart here. There's the point. I would rather protect you. I'm not in this business to take advantage of anybody. I'm in this business to help you, and I want to make sure that you're helped. So what I've done is I've created free training. And on every page on the site, at the bottom of every cart page, is a little warning. Not something like nuclear, but just, hey, make sure you get your cart pre-approved. I show you the steps to do it so that you put all the burden on them without you having to look at codes and decipher the hieroglyphics that are food codes. So that's what I've done. And I hope you'll take advantage of that. And that you'll, if you'll spend a little bit of time here, okay, a little bit of time, you'll end up more successful, faster, and not waste one penny on options and accessories and stuff or the wrong cart and save you money. That's better. Whether you're buying it from me or not, you always need to do this. I hope that helps you. If you have other questions, hit me up, okay? I'll be happy. I'm usually on here. I try to watch this closely, and I'll try to answer all your questions. But I made this video specifically for anyone that asked me this question because it's the number one question I get. Plus, it's at the top 10 list of our top 10 questions asked a day. So, hope that helps, and I'll see you later. Thanks.